The Supreme Court judgment is absolutely clear.
The appointment which they tried to make in Kannur, Supreme Court has not said that. Supreme Court has not cast any aspersion on the Vice Chancellor. Vice Chancellor, I personally would say that she was working in a very efficient manner. Even the Supreme Court has not found any fault with her. Supreme Court has said that the process of selection and appointment was illegal right from day one. Supreme Court has not damned the Vice Chancellor. Supreme Court has merely pointed out that a selection process which is repugnant to the UGC regulations, any appointment done through that selection process which is repugnant shall be void ab initio. The words are to be kept in mind. Void ab initio means that the person will not be entitled to the benefits after retirement. That is what ab initio means. In my letter, I only tried to suggest to them an honorable exit. I have not pointed out that you are inefficient, you are not doing your work properly, you are doing this thing wrong. No. As Chancellor of the universities, more so as Governor of Kerala, it is my duty to uphold the Constitution, to uphold the judgment of the Supreme Court. Supreme Court has said that any appointment made where panel is not there, only one single name is recommended, it will be void ab initio. If any person other than the academics is part of the selection committee, appointment will be void ab initio. Supreme Court has not found fault. Honorable Supreme Court has not found fault with the individual vice chancellors. I have not tried to blame them for anything. I have just pointed out that this is what Honorable Supreme Court has said. Since all these nine, these are not only nine, two other cases I am studying because they are the first term vice chancellors. So I am studying, I have sought opinion, legal opinion, whether the first term recently appointed, created universities. Because Supreme Court does not make any exception. Therefore, because that matter is under study, under consideration, therefore those two universities I have not included. Maybe tomorrow, maybe day after tomorrow, when the final opinion comes, I'm holding meetings with the lawyers, talking to the lawyers, and I'm not just depending on one opinion, one person's opinion. I'm talking to so many people, very senior. Don't forget that I'm myself a lawyer. And although I have not practiced for a long time,